Myself, Sachin Deshmukh, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see and learn what is a Cipolletti Weir and how we can find out the discharge over this Cipolletti Weir. These are some photographs of Cipolletti Weir. Looking to this particular photograph, you will come to know this is a trapezoidal weir. Yes, this trapezoidal weir is called as a Cipolletti weir. This is a sloping side, this is a horizontal bottom, and again this is a sloping side. This is constructed in a channel. Here water is flowing over. In the another photograph you can see water is flowing over this Cipolletti weir, and this top line, it is called as a crest. Now what is the Cipolletti weir? It is a particular type of trapezoidal weir, or we can say it is a combination of a rectangular weir as well as triangular weir. See here, if you can take this line, vertical line, this vertical line, it becomes a rectangular, and this sloping portion and this vertical line, in between these, this triangular portion 1 and triangular portion 2, these are the triangular weir. So it is a combination of rectangular as well as triangular. Again we can say it is a particular type of trapezoidal weir where the sloping sides of which has an inclination of 1 horizontal to 4 vertical. And this weir was invented by an Italian engineer, Cipolletti, in 1887. As I told, it is a combination of rectangular as well as triangular. The discharge of rectangular and triangular is combined. The discharge over a rectangular weir, it is 2/3 CD under root 2G LH raised to 3/2, where CD is coefficient of discharge, L is length of the channel, H is head, and for triangular it is 8/15 CD under root 2G tan theta by 2 h raised to 5/2. Here length is not there, that is length of the weir is not there, here only angle is there, so tan theta by 2 h raised to 5/2. Now particularly one thing comes in our mind, what is a notch and a weir? Actually notch is a thin plate and which is located or constructed in the channel. Rather we can say weir is in a big scale, which we can construct in the canal sections, big sections, where we can find out the discharge through that canals. And we have seen some notches in our laboratory to where we can find out the discharge in the given section of that particular small channels. Now, see here, the total discharge, it is a combination of rectangular as well as triangular, where CD1 and CD2 respectively, these are the coefficient of discharges for rectangular as well as triangular. The purpose of slope obtained on side is to obtain an increased discharge through the triangular portion of the weir, which otherwise would have been decreased due to the end contractions in the case of rectangular weir. See here, the statement is for this one. Due to this sloping side, the decrease in the discharge due to the end contraction is compensated by this triangular portion, this and this triangular portion. So as in the case of trapezoidal wear, here the Cipolletti Weir is also the discharge. We can calculate as Q1 and Q2, that is rectangular as well as triangular. This is with the end contraction. This is the formula with the end contraction and with the triangular notch. And from this, if you can equate this, you will get tan theta by 2 is 1 by 4. Put this value, you will get this equation. Thus, adding these two, the discharge for the Cipolletti Weir is given by Q is equal to 2 by 3 CD under root 2 GL 0.2H H raised to 3 by 2 plus 2 by 15 when we are going to add tan theta by 2 is 1 by 4 sloping side. You will get 2 by 15 CD under root 2 G H raised to 5 by 2. You will get Q is equal to 2 thirds CD under root 2 G L H raised to 3 by 2. Equation number 1. And if you can put the values of this CD, etc., you will get Q is equal to 1.86 LH raised to 3 by 2. So by comparing equation 1 and 2, the value of coefficient of discharge for a Cipolletti Weir is obtained as 0.632. And equation 2, this one, that is 1.86 LH raised to 3 by 2, is applicable only if the velocity of approach is neglected. So VA, we can calculate, that is neglected. However, if the velocity of approach, that is VA, is to be considered, then the equation 1, this one, the equation 1, this equation 1 becomes Q is equal to 1.86 LH 1 raised to 3 by 2 minus HA raised to 3 by 2. So H1 is nothing but H plus HA, which is equal to H plus VA square upon 2G. HA is nothing but VA square upon 2G. VA is the velocity of approach. VA is nothing but the velocity of approach. Now we'll solve one problem on this particular Cipolletti Weir. How it works, how we can find out the discharge over this. Let's see. A water flows through a rectangular channel 1 meter wide and 0.5 meter deep. And then over a sharp crested Cipolletti Weir of crest length 0.6 meter. If the water level in the channel is 0.2 to 5 meter above the weir crest, calculate the discharge over the weir. Take coefficient of discharge as 0.6 and make correction for velocity of approach. Read the problem once again. Here, if the velocity of approach is neglected, first case, then for a Cipolletti Weir, Q is equal to 2 thirds CD under 2G LHS to 3 by 2. If velocity of approach is taken into account, again the formula is going to change. So CD is given to you 0.6. Length is given to you 0.6 meters. Head is 0.2 to 5 meter. Put these values. We will get 0.1135 meter cube per second. Now velocity of approach. VA is equal to upon area. You will get 0.2 to 7 meter per second. Then we can calculate HA, which is nothing but VA square upon 2G. It comes 0.2 to 6 meter, and then find out H1 we required to find out when we are going to consider the velocity of approach. H1 is equal to H plus HA. So HA is nothing but VA square upon 2G. So for velocity of approach taken into consideration, Q is equal to 1.86 L into bracket H1 raised to 3 by 2 minus HA raised to 3 by 2. Put these values here also, we will get 0.1153 meter cube per second. here it is 0.1135 and here 0.1153. When velocity of approach is taken into account, small increase we can observe over here when velocity of approach is taken into account. This is the figure again for your convenience. This is a knot, weir, trapezoidal weir, discharge over this. These are, take a pause and just go through these questions. These are the answers for these questions. First study rectangular, triangular, and then go for trapezoidal weir. These are the reference books for you. You can find some more data from Google also. You can find out some web series, web on Google, and just find, go through this. Thank you.